Welcome everyone to my new episode on Cardano's price prediction and discussion about the market, June, July and so on. Let's talk about pretty much honestly what's happening out here and make sure you have a benefit once finishing this video, which is my main point and desire. At the moment, we're talking about a cryptocurrency which clearly shows based on the volume of transactions for the last 24 hours that is still alive. Unfortunately, we have to look into the volume because the price action is not showing that. The price action in correlation with a bullish context, right? It's definitely not showing that. Now, before we talk about that one, let's see what's happening into the crypto total market cap, which sits on $2.38 trillion. It sits on that level after confirming again that we just broke out of a correction environment. And we did that successfully. Now, this confirmation here is amazing. It's pretty much exactly what we need to talk about the highs. It's pretty much exactly what we need for the future to be delivered into the all-time high. You cannot expect basically the all-time high to be delivered without taking lows of certain structures. Lows of these structures have been taken. Lows of the upper minor consolidation has been taken now. Yesterday, we got the CPI, positive, FOMC meeting, FOMC news out there. They kept the rates the same. Markets dumped on that. So we had a huge volatility. And today, of course, we still have a bit of reaction on that volatility sector. Not a big deal here at all for the market cap, other than it is finding a good time above significant levels. And it shows a lot more bullish than bearish. In order to transform this into a bearish discussion, we need to confirm below a level of the downtrending environment sector with a correction and downtrending line, right? So there's a lot of the work from the bears to confirm that way. It would look like that. Trending line continues and you retouch it and confirm and break below the structure. You break below 200 days and you can clearly confirm you're going back to the 1.5 trillion, which is at the moment not really the case, as you can see. And it's less likely. Going forward, folks, before we touch bases with Cardano, make sure to subscribe to the channel and like the video, including the one-on-one coaching if you care about education, if you think it's important for your skills and knowledge to be developed towards financial success and performance. Then check out at the end of the video, I'll talk about it, including my trading journey. You can be part of that one as well. Let's see what's happening on Cardano, folks. This is the case right here. I mean, I've been indeed talking about it for a while, and a lot of you might say that, you know, Scrumbo, you're just putting out here a couple of directions most of the time. In a bullish environment, they are bullish. Yet the market is having sell-offs, it's having retracements, and it's having difficulties breaking above certain levels that are extremely, extremely clear. That's true. That's exactly what happens before every single significant and meaningful movement, guys. Exactly what you believe when you look at the price action of Cardano. What do we talk about even the movement to the downside, which is less likely to appear than the movement to the upside? And we're trading probabilities. You should not forget about it. We're not trading anything on safety. We don't have a direction locked in and we are riding that. There's no such a thing. We're trading probabilities. Probabilities are always in both directions. It's never one of the directions turned away or turned off by an energy, you know, somehow it just interferes and turns off the sell button from the exchanges. No, folks, we're confirming in this demand zone. We're, you know, trying to confirm a few times already. We're trying to hold on this level a few times already. It's, you know, acting decently so far, but it's not really satisfying a lot of the people. I'm just going to take those circles out. You saw them. You've recognized, you know, we're actually putting together three circles right there, just like we put together before Back in the day, on the 6th of February, we printed a movement of 65% in 37 days, so we did about 2% a day on average. 65%, you give me that, you're gonna bring me exactly into slightly above the golden pocket. But that's gonna be fine because, you know, these highs right here are not gonna be the easiest job to break out, and there might be a bit of fight going on at that level. However, what matters here for Cardano right now? I mean, you got certain levels that you must clear, such as 200 days moving average and downtrending channel resistance line. The upside is acting like a channel, the bottom side is flat. So the indicators are forming a tension in between, right? You got your flat demand zone and you have a pressing trending line towards the downside. This is obviously a situation that creates tension between the traders, between the investors, between people. As soon as you clear that, you should not target anything below 0.65, which means 65 cents. That is the only thing we gotta clear on the daily. Close above that, show me strength, and we go to the 65 cents. So that means we're just away 12% to have a signal that is going to be very likely printing movement to 65%. So you're just 12% away to print a such signal, which is very likely. Not a signal that will drive you 100%, but very likely into 65 cents, folks. And that's the beauty of the markets when you know how to think about them, that you might only need 10% in order to achieve 50 or 60 or 65, because that 10% will print sufficient patterns and indicators around the board, which will generate almost automatically, I would say, but I would say naturally and organically, the movement additionally expected after that. That's the case for Cardano, that's the case for many of the altcoins. They're not sitting in a bad shape, and they're having a great time consolidating, selling off so many times, and playing with your nerves. It's exactly what happens, folks. If we retrace here into the wick, if we take out the wick by a couple of, you know, by 10 cents, sorry, 10 cents is a lot, by a cent or 2 or 3 cents, I'm not gonna have an issue, right? Because then the pattern would look like this. Correction, consolidation, taking out a liquidity, and the market from there goes to the highs. This pattern is extremely popular. So at the moment, I would only be scared if the market goes down, and when it comes back up, it's going to get reversed from the bottom level of the consolidation phase, which means if 43 cents, 44 cents, if we break here, 43, 44 rejects me, I'll have a problem with that, because that then, you know, we're bearish, we're going back to 25 cents and we are just liquidating everyone. You're just going to have a movement of 69% retracement in the bull market, and it's, you know, something terrible, honestly, which is why it's extremely less likely to appear and to happen. But that's the reality, folks. I must tell you that version as well. It does exist and it sits on the table. That scenario is also having a level of probability as well. Now, the highest probability here is to continuously see the rejection of continuing lower, pushing basically to the resistance line again and try and do the breakout. That's it, right? This is what not only everyone is looking for, but most likely the markets are also trying to hunt in the upcoming period. To push for that breakout, confirm, and you're good to go. You're gonna fly. Of course, you need BTC as well. In order for Cardano to get back into these levels, you need BTC on all-time high as well. Other than that, as you see, we're speaking about crypto, which is, you know, near to the all-time high, and this guy right here has retraced 47% and it's dying around that level. Huge difference. Bitcoin 3 days ago was sitting on 70 grand, which is $4,000 away from the all-time high. And Cardano was, you know, 40-45% away, from not all-time high, it's excluded folks from the top they made on the rally on the 80 cents. Right? So if we just bring out the charts here for the weekly, you know, you might get a bit of a painful feeling out there that, you know, you're consolidating here, you have slowed down, you're just, you know, trying to construct and build. It most likely looks like this, right? This is where it looks like, right? Try to slow down here and slowly grind up, and then just at some point you accelerate. And you accelerate. That's exactly how it looks like. Beautiful, folks. Enjoy once again if you care about education. Real education and how to trade from A to Z on how do I trade, which is something that is, you know, total different than what we talk out here. I mean, doing a proper technical analysis for trading, for positions, for setups is total different. Check out the one-on-one coaching. I'll explain you at the end of the video. I mean, right now, including done for you trading. Subscribe and enjoy. And now I would like to talk for those of you that believe in education and care about their performance. So it's time to share more details about my one-on-one coaching program. This is done with me live, where I'll take you by hand, just like I said, and teach you how to trade from A to Z, which means starting from the mindset psychology side into the technical analysis, understanding the language of the market, encrypting the charts, and being familiar with the language in terms of what does the market communicates with you, understand the whole process, and then know how to react to those messages that the markets are delivering to you guys. Knowing how to react obviously is a sophisticated process. How to trade, when to trade, what to trade, when to exit, how to exit, and how to deal with an active trade. All the situations that are considered complex and a trader needs to know. Whether we talk about part-time or full-time trading, it doesn't matter. What matters is you need to increase your educational level in order to perform in the markets correctly and most likely in a predictable way. Trading is not gambling. Not at all. Trading is a type of activity where a person is trading an asset when the probabilities of a direction are very high. So he has the ability to recognize those moments when a probability compared to the other, so a energy of bullishness or bearishness, is having a very, very strong possibilities of going into a direction. This is when a trader steps in and it is an advantage towards the market, so he's trying to make money with that. That's the whole idea of the process. It's definitely not something that has a very, very high level of unknown and random outcome at all the times. No, there are situations like that as well. I can confirm that. Been trading since 2014 full time. But the idea is that there are situations where the randomness or the unpredictability is not high. And that makes the spots for the traders. So check out the video to understand how does it work. Register now for a free conversation with me, a one-on-one coaching where I'll take you by hand between 4 to 6 weeks and teach you how to trade on Zoom conversations with homework, with exercises, with everything that is needed. Just like for the completely done for you on the trading side, if you'd like to be part of my trades, you can definitely do so without any prior fees. Just a commission from the profits we earn. Commission is paid by you every 7 days. This is my journey. You can check out the links in the description area, in the comments area for everything. It's completely done for you. We are using our ChatGPT bot for trading. It helps us to perform, it helps us to run the analysis, and it helps for the accuracy side. So it's done through API trading permission, and it's simple, straightforward. I can explain you more. Just reach out to me if you think this is a good option for you. Have a good time around it. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, and we'll talk to you soon.